but now I look like I'm back to my normal self. There has been a lot of, it's just emotions being emotion and life, you know, happening. And hello, ding ding, something's in your inbox. Yes, it is. Well, no duh, you're alive. And when you're not alive, there won't be nothing there. There will, but you won't know. You won't care, right? Being Brandon, what are you doing? Brandon and William in the house. The dudes are here. We can begin. Let's begin. Now that we girls have some dance partners, we can begin. And you will share William and Brandon. And that is how it is, okay? Right? What do you think, Kathleen? Stop trying to hog the guys. Hey. Just a second. Hold on to. Show me the way. Every day. Now, you'll turn that down unless you want to be muted. So, I was just thinking about something is this. What are your intentions, right? Well, not right, because you didn't even hear me talk yet. But in my mind, I'm thinking, right? Here's the thing. We are in January, February, March, April, May. That's month number 5. And today is the 5th. Is that correct? I think it is. Is it? There's not enough guys. Listen, I think there are. I think those two are bringing it to the table and that we can share them around the dance floor. Right? That's funny. Anyway, so I can just hear William now, because on his Instagram page he likes to say happy Monday, to God be the glory. And now William is saying, I am the life of the party, happy Sunday, to God be the glory. Anyway, so let's think about this. It is the 5th. Okay, so here's what's going on today in my world. Is the reset doors open? Hey, come in. And everybody introduced themselves, and they love to tell me all the things, and I love to know all the things, and we're going to proceed. But what are your intentions with this month? And if you're in my reset, my intention is for you to show up. Your job is to show up every day. Every day, you're to show up, and I'll bring the rest. That's your job, okay? That's pretty easy, right? Until you like, these things are starting to add up, Tanya. It's a lot of things you want me to do. Anyway, look, you got to do all the things, and we're going to learn how to do them. But the point is this. What are your intentions for this month, for this year? We're in the 5th month. We're going to be going into June, okay? That's next month. And the year is going to be half over. And at the end of the year, we're going to be saying the same thing. Well, you know, I didn't do the thing. I didn't lose any weight on that, you know, whole food plant-based diet. I didn't lose any weight meatless Mondays. Well, what'd you replace the meat with? I don't know. Cotton candy and Pop-Tarts and a bowl of Lucky Charms. You know that cereal is a very high-calorie food. But anyway, the point is, just because you're not having meat doesn't mean you're going to get results. Just because you're going on plants, just because you're eating vegan, doesn't mean you're going to get results. No, it doesn't. You could actually gain weight. Yes, you could. I had a video I did a few weeks ago. I was going to put it up on YouTube today, but it didn't want to load. Anyway, but it was talking about that. Gaining weight on a raw vegan diet. I know, isn't that disturbing? Because you're like striving to be, maybe you aren't, but let's say you are. You're striving to be raw vegan, even low-fat raw vegan, and you're not losing weight. You're gaining weight. How is that? Well, why are you putting 15 extra dates in each smoothie? Why? Calories matter. People don't like that. They really don't. Of course you can eat more whole plant foods than you can chocolates, because they're less calorie dense for the most part, right? Anyway, but that's not what I was going to talk about. Staying the course is what I was going to talk about. What are your intentions, and are you staying the course? When you're filling out your journal or looking away and beginning another day, are you not getting results because you are not really doing the thing? You're not staying the course long enough. Let's say, for example, a Renata. Let's say that Renata is trying to, I won't even use Renata because she's doing the thing. That's not even appropriate. That is disrespectful. Renata, I'm sorry. That was disrespectful. Anyway, so let's just say this. you're wanting to do the thing, so you start digging. You're trying to find gold, right? You're trying to find the pot of gold, the youth, the vitality, the health, the slimness. You want to button your pants. Yes, you do. All the things. Maybe you want to get a boyfriend, a girlfriend. Maybe, I don't know, maybe you think, well, if I felt better, I could get a dog. I could walk the thing. I mean, the sweet puppy. You know, all the things you want to do, whatever it is. You know, maybe think, I'd clean up this house if I felt like getting up. I'd clean up, but I don't. So turn the TV up, you know? Anyway, so you want to find gold though. So you go out, you got your shovel, you're ready, you're prepared, you got your water bottle. You bought all the shiny things to go out on the adventure, right? You got all the bling to go with it. You went to REI, you know what I'm saying? There was no, you spared no expense. You're like, if I had the good backpack, I could do the thing. If I had the right digging tool, I could do the thing. If I had whatever, if I had the right blender, I could do the thing. Not for digging, because that makes no sense. But anyway, so you go out. You got all your things, okay? You got your ponytail. You are prepared, all right? And you start digging. Well, you dig down. You got about a 4 or 6 feet you're digging down. And it starts to get hot as heck. And you start to sweat. And you start to hit rocks. And it starts to get tough. And you think, this, I'm not finding any gold. You're like, and then your noisy brain starts to play, and you don't stay the course. No, you don't. Because you start thinking, and you start seeing this other spot, or the shiny thing. The fresh dirt, the different spot, to where you think you might should be, because there's so much dang noise on the internet. Okay? So anyway, you go over there and you start digging. You just leave the hole. You go over there, you start digging. You dig down again about 4 or 6 feet. Okay? And guess what happens? You hit some water. You hit some mud, it's like bricks down there. And you're like, this ain't working either. Right? So you stop digging. So guess what you do then? You get to another spot. And you start digging again. And then you're like, well, maybe this isn't even, and then you think, well, maybe it's in the cave. So you start going in the cave, and you go back to the store, and you get the shiny things. You got to get the, I don't know, maybe it's ice. You got to get the ice pick. I don't know what people use. Okay, but you have all the things you need. You're spending money, time, and most of all, energy. And most of all, what's worse is you're expending your little bit of confidence you have in yourself. Because every time you go to a different digging hole, you leave some confidence behind, right? So, time goes on. You have all these digging spots. It looks like that movie Holes. Do y'all remember that movie? Where those kids, they didn't do right, and they had to go to this like dude ranch, and they dig holes all day, and there was stuff down in there. There was holes. Okay? I know some people that could really, they couldn't benefit. I don't know. Sometimes you can bring problems on yourself, is all I'm saying. Anyway, so, but what I'm saying is, eventually you've got nowhere, and guess what? You've dug 40 or 50 or 60 feet down in the ground. But you've never got to gold because you didn't stay the course. No, you didn't. Bam. You did not stay the course. Occasionally, I have people come into my 30-day immersion program, which is what it is. It's at least 35, 40 hours of me teaching everything I know with every last breath and every spirit and soul light crystal in me, okay? And it'll be like, well, I didn't hear, you know, you know, if you sign up for a course at college and you don't show up, you don't know what Mr. Magoo was teaching, right? You buy a book at the bookstore and he set it on the shelf, you don't know what it says. You didn't show up at class, babe. You didn't show up for the practice. You know what I'm saying? What are you laughing at, Carly? So, anyway, think about that. You are digging for nothing. You're never going to get the goal unless you dig a little deeper, right? You got to break it down to build it up. You got to dig a little deeper to get to the treasures, right? You got to peel back the layers to get to the fresh, right? Because right now you're an onion and you got all that stuff on you that's like the flaky old part. You know, the part you'd never eat. The part that wears my mom out if it accidentally gets in her salad. She's weirded by that. Is she on here? Anyway, no. You want down there. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, that's just something to think about. You know, we let things distract us. Maybe it's not the other shiny hole over there or the fresh dirt. You haven't heard that all day, have you, shiny hole? there's a lot going on in this world. Anyway, what I was just thinking was, maybe it's that your family talks you out of it. Maybe it's that you heard the riffraff and the yin-yang and the ding-a-lings talk. They're not ding-a-lings. They're just people that believe in keto diets, okay? I mean, you might get the keto itch and the keto stank. But okay, look. Anyway, there's a lot of confusion. Maybe you don't have kids that are doing right. Maybe there's stress in your life. Friends and family, the last 2 weeks of my life, like, I have heard myself say this before, that I'm like, I can't believe this stress. And you look around and you're like, okay, I'm feeling like I'm streamlined. I don't feel like I'm the eye of the storm. And you're really not. But there are certain things in your life that you can't really, like, put up borders and barriers to externally, though you can internally. Like, how are you going to deal with that? You know? You got to put your blinders on, said Brandon. Yes, you do. It's a shiny hole, Kathleen. It really is. Oh, man. Parasites, well, I'll tell you this, black walnut extract and wormwood extract are great for getting parasites out of the colon. Yes, they are. So, I was just thinking about that, though. What's the destination you want to be? I mean, it's even like I would use that analogy before about the bars. We think it's so hard, and you're like, my gosh, I can't continue to dig like this on and on and on and on. Well, that's because you're never getting the prize, right? I mean, this is like, you've got this good boyfriend, and he's, you know, he'll work on your screen porch. Look, eventually you need to give him a little sugar on the cheek, you know, a little pat on the bottom. Baby, that's great, you know. Like, you gotta have some encouragement with these things. What do you think, Brandon? Think about that, though, with the barge. You're cruising along. You know how big a barge is and heavy, right? And it's on its way. And it's steady and it's slow, but it's heavy. And it's really set in its course. But it's going the wrong way. And when you start trying to turn this barge around, it's slow and you got to turn. It's like you're on the sit and spin, but you weigh 300 pounds. Girlfriend, you got to put in that is some arm work right there. That's some forearm work. Yes, it is. You could even be getting cramps in your fingers, you know? You were beyond the weight limit of sit and spin. What are you doing? Oh, yes, wormwood and black walnut. Kathleen loves it when I'm speaking of the herbs and things. Kathleen, enlighten us, would you? Kathleen knows all the things. She really does. Kathleen did have a natural health store and, all the herbs. She knows all the things. The oils, the crystals. She can hook you up. She really can. Anyway, so, Mudge, we're turning the barge. And it's little by little, you know. And you keep on thinking. And you let go some by you looked away at the shiny hole. You went to dig somewhere else. And guess what? The barge kind of went back to the same course. Then you got to go back to the steering wheel. You got to turn again and turn again. And it never gets easier. No, it doesn't, because you don't stay the course. What do you think? What do you want in your life? Continue digging until you hit the gold. What do you want in your life? Somebody tell me what they want beyond my own thoughts. You know, what's DK? Denmark? Or Donna Karen? That's a clothing brand. Somebody tell me what they want. What is it you want? What's stopping you? Tell me what's stopping you from doing it. By the time I'm done with this reset, I'm going to send these people off with a satchel of tools in there. And I'm going to say, may the force be with you, because they're going to have everything they need. But you know what could stop them? Shiny holes, Carly. That's what. Shiny holes. I'll tell you what. What's exactly? Tell me what is stopping you. I'm waiting. Nobody wants to talk about their shiny holes, right? Right, Brandon? Brandon, do you have dreadlocks? My daughter stays the course. She really does. She has intentions for her life and intentions of when she lets people into her inner circle, or intentions for the day, getting up. What are the intentions for the day? It's so beautiful, you know? I want celery to go down in price. That's what I want. Well, Kelly. Sutton Kelly, too. I don't know what to tell you about that other than buy it in bulk. You can get organic celery over at my Costco. It's pretty cheap, and it's by, they change up the kind sometimes. Usually it's organic, girl. Just ignore that curl weed. I want more time. And Annie, we're fixing to create more time in that group, even though you're fixing to give me an hour of your life every day. I mean it. You're going to show up at that pool. Show up at the pool means every day. Have you ever heard that story about Michael Phelps and his coach? You know, Michael Phelps was always a champion swimmer as a kid on every level he got to. But he was also like the kind of kid that goofed up and he was just good at it anyway. You know, he's the kind of kid that like didn't really, the kind of person that doesn't have to listen in class, but then they make straight A's. That wasn't me. See, I didn't listen in class and then I made a D, but that was passing. That's all that matters. And I was like, I can really do all the things. I can date. I can do the dancing. I can never study. I can sleep in class and I can still pass. We talk ourselves out of what we want to do. Yes, we do. What was I talking about? Oh, yes, Michael Phelps. So he gets this different coach, and the coach has been watching him this whole time thinking, this kid, he is like a really goof off. You know, he's just his ego and all this. And Michael tells the coach what he wants, okay? He wants to be going to the Olympics, and he wants to win. He wants to be the best in the world. And the coach is like, all right, well, here's what we need to do. Every day you're going to show up at the pool, and here's what we're going to do. They have a strategic plan like a coach would do, you know. So Michael comes, and he's doing, you know, the breaststrokes for all week or whatever they do in the pool. And then he goes out, and he you know, some things happen. And one morning, he's like, text the coach up. He's like, yeah, I don't think I'll make it today. And the coach is like, listening, you know, well, why is that? And Michael says, whatever. And the coach says, see you at the pool. It happens every so often. Why is that? Because we don't want to put in the work, right? We feel like, well, I've done the backstroke before, but how many times do you need to do it to master it, to be the best in your world? You need to do it again. And if you don't continue to show up to do the practice, you're not going to get the thing you want. And the coach knew, unless you show up to do it again and again and again and again, you're not going to master it. No, you're not. So every day, Annie is going to show up at the pool. And we're going to talk about motivation. We're going to talk about the group. We're going to elevate beautiful posts in the group. We're going to talk about recipes, how to do it. We're going to talk about every last thing. We're going to have lessons every day, and we're going to up our game. Yes, we are. Yeah, I'll pay for organic celery any day rather than the Dr. Bill later. That's exactly right, Carly. It's a strange connection. It's freezing on every other word. Well, y'all can hear me after if you would like to get into some smooth video after this. Okay, maybe it'll stay up. Thinking about that, though, do you continue to be frustrated with yourself because you continue to try to get to the goal? You're digging. But every time you get about 5 or 6 feet down, you get frustrated and you quit digging. So you go to another hole and you start digging again. You never get to the thing. But you're always digging. You're just not digging deep enough and hard enough and consistent enough, right? So, I love y'all. I hope you have a beautiful day.